Today we're going to make a mosaic with Tinkercad and the sketch tool. So let's get cracking. If this is your first time using Tinkercad, you can find it at tinkercad.com. This is what the home looks like. This is where you can find your designs. All the designs are saved to the cloud. You can see they are default private. This one I created a share link. If you want to make a brand new one, you simply hit create new 3D design. This is where you name your projects. I'm going to call mine Heart Mosaic and press enter. Just like that, the project is created. If you click right here, you bounce back to the workspace and your project is automatically saved just like that. And if you want to re-enter a project, you simply hit tinker this. Now I'm going to build this project with a basic shape. I'm going to bring out the star and show you how I would use it. The shape I used in the earlier project was a heart. If we type heart, they show us all the hearts are available, and I used this one right here. I'm going to just leave it in the corner as a point of reference. I'm using this star to make today's project quick. We could also import a SVG, like if you had a logo or something from your business. I've got lots of videos about bringing in SVGs. I'll put links to them up there. Just understand that it's the exact same technique, just with your SVG file. I'm going to start this project by straightening out this star. Notice if you spin it 17 or 18 degrees, it is nice and flat, lines up on these lines. We can zoom in and double check. And that's good enough that I can work with it. That just makes it easier as I'm sketching. I'm going to make this a little thinner. And now, friends, I want to make the walls for our mosaic. We're going to do that with the sketch tool. When we bring this out, it fits on a 20 by 20 grid. So I'm going to just line it up. You can see that it is lined up with that line. Now I can zoom out. Hold down the mouse, scroll wheel, and pan, or use the shortcut. Now that shape is simply a star. The only thing you can change is its measurements. What we're gonna do is use this sketch tool to trace it. Notice I cannot get right on the grid, so I'm gonna simply go here and shut it off. And then these are straight lines, so I can just click and connect to make the star shape that we wanna play with for the rest of our project. If you needed a curve, you can press number 2 to switch to Bezier curve mode, and then these you can click and twist to make the shape as cool as you want. I'm going to leave that one wackadoodle. I'll fix it in a moment. I'm going to press number 1 to go back to lines and simply connect and connect and connect all the way back. With my shape completed, I can now double click to edit it. Click on this line. Notice it does give us dimensions, which are cool. If they're ever in your way, you can shut dimensions off just like that. And then down here, we've got 3 different choices. We can make it a corner, we can make it smooth, or we can break the handle so that it swaps. Well, I want it to be a corner, so I'm going to hit the number 1 and bang, that is back to the line I want. I will show you that if you double click, it makes it into an auto curve, which is kind of cool. It's like we just made an instant starfish. If we double click again, it is now back to the star. If you ever don't like what you did, you can just do Control Z. Now here's the amazing thing. This is why we did this. If we click outside and finish, we can now click down here and we can choose stroke settings. I want to enable strokes for this because this is where I make my mosaic shape. I'm going to choose a width of 1. This will be the outside of the shape. We can pick whether it is inside, outside, or centered. I'm going to stay with inside. That way it comes inside the line. And then we could also adjust what the corners are like. I do want these to be sharp. Quite often, I choose round. When I hit finish sketch, bingo, we have got an awesome star shape that we can use for our fun little mosaic. Notice we can drag the handle down or we can click in the box and type a number, like I'm going to make it 2 millimeters. Now I want to make a back plate. We're going to do that by doing Control D. Once again, we're going to edit the sketch. And then when I click on this, I'm going to go back here, shut it off, and hit finish sketch. Now I've got my back plate. Let's set that to 0.5 millimeters. Pick a different color. Let's go with a crazy pink. And bingo, we've now got the walls of our mosaic, and we've got the fun star. Let's quickly make the mosaic part. First, I'm going to put my grid back on to 1 millimeter. Let's quickly grab the sketch tool, and let's drop it in place. Notice I lined it up with the grid so it's easy to make. I'm going to choose to make a diamond shape that I put inside here. You can pick whatever measurements you want. I'm just going to click, 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 and finish. And then I can double check to see if I like it. Notice if we double click, I could drag this up, down, whatever I want. You have complete control of making what you like. Once I hit finish, I'm gonna go back to the shape and I'm gonna do the walls. I want these to be 0.75. So I'm gonna just type 0.75 and press enter. And then this is gonna be kind of slick right here. I'm gonna make this one go to the outside, all right? And hit finish sketch. I'm gonna set its height to 5. And then we're gonna do control D. And when I double click, I'm gonna take the second one. Once I click on it, I'm gonna set it to the inside. Bang. So we've just got two sets of these by really only doing the technique once. Now what this does is it lets us pick the cool colors. I'm gonna set this one to a height of 10. These numbers are crazy big at the moment, but that makes it easier when we're doing our next step. So I'm gonna set this to, let's say, green. I'm gonna set the inside to yellow. Easy to differentiate, and then let's make the pattern. Control D, nudge it until they break apart. I think that's gonna work for my idea, and do Control D to make the pattern bigger than the project. I'm gonna grab all of these and do Control D. And make that so it's in the middle area. If you want to make sure it's perfect, don't forget you can do flat view and top view and double check the alignment until you are absolutely happy. Notice if you need a half, you can just switch your nudge to 0.5 or whatever, and bingo, you've got it created. I need this to be larger than my project, so I'm going to do Control D. I'm going to use Shift Nudge to move it up and get it to the exact spot for my pattern. If we look right now, we can tell that this is larger than our project, so it is perfect. And now what I need to do is get them grouped separately. I'm gonna click on right view, I'm gonna hide anything that's in the way, and I just wanna grab the green ones. So notice I'm just barely touching them, and I'm going to group them, Control G, and then I'm gonna hide them. Now I can grab the yellow ones, and I'm gonna do Control G, and when I bring everything back, they are two different pieces. I'm gonna switch back to perspective mode and let me show you why this works. We're gonna take this one and do Control D. We are going to edit it. Now we wanna make it wide enough to cut off the scraps that we don't need. So I'm just gonna click on it again. I'm gonna make sure it goes outside line. And then I want the width to be crazy huge. So notice it's gonna be larger than that shape. Let's hit finish sketch. And just like that, we've got the part that we're gonna use to trim our pattern so it fits inside our star. Let's line this up for cutting. I'm gonna grab our patterns and I'm gonna just use the arrows to move it to where I think is cool. Notice if you use the centering tool, it doesn't necessarily go to the center of the shape, so you need to pick a spot that you think is cool. I like that one right there. I'm gonna take my cutting hole and now I'm gonna make it taller and turn it into a hole so that it's gonna cut away all the pieces of the design. We need to cut away the yellow and the green separately so that way it's easier to do multicolor. I'm gonna quickly do Control D. Click on one of those and do Shift click on the green. And when we do Control G to group, it is now cut inside that shape. Of course, I'm gonna click on the other hole, Shift click on the yellow and do Control G so it fits as well. That's our mosaic pattern. Remember we had these heights so different that was to make them easy to grab. I'm gonna set this to a level of 2 millimeters and press enter. I'm gonna set this one to 1.5 millimeters and press enter. And then I'm gonna make this stick out further so that it goes past the shape. So we're simply gonna edit the sketch. And when we click on this, remember how we said inside? Right now we are gonna switch it to center. Now we can simply click finish. Bang. All right, so that, my friends, is our mosaic. We've got a sweet pattern. It's gonna be easy to print multicolor. We've got the frame on the outside. And then I'm gonna add a piece of text, which I'm gonna do as a number. I'm gonna cruise this text out and I wanna set it in the center there. Notice it landed on the pink. I'm gonna pretend that I'm giving something that says number 1 to somebody. I like that number one. It looks cool. I do want you to know there are custom fonts you can use. I've got videos about that as well. I'll put a link up above. I'm going to set this to size 2 so it'll poke out above those. I do want to align it to the middle. Let's do Shift Select L for Align. Click on the blue one and make it the master. I'm going to center it that way, but notice if you center it this way, it does not line up quite the way we want. I think I like it right there. I'm going to also do Alt Shift Shrink and get the size I want. Alt Shift goes around center, which is pretty slick, but I do want to adjust this height back to size 2 so we've got the multi-level. Friends, with our cute little mosaic created, let's send it for 3D printing. I'm going to start by clicking on the outside, and I'm going to do these as separate pieces. I am just not a fan of the OBJ steps. It adds extra colors to my printer, and I just find it annoying. So I'm going to call this Star Mosaic 1. As you can see, I did that earlier. I'm just going to hit yes to save over it, and then I'm going to hide that part. Let's click on the next layer. Once again, same steps, export, STL. And I'm going to call this one too. Once again, save and replace. Hide that one as well. Let's go to the yellow. Export. STL. Of course, this one gets a 3. And save. And hide. Finally, the green one. Export. STL. Make this one 4. And save. And hide. And finally, our number. Export, STL, give it a 5, and we're done. Of course, now we can bounce to Bamboo Lab Studio. I'm going to click Add, and let's find all of those files and grab them all at once. Tell it open. Yes, it is a single object, multiple parts. They are all layered perfectly. All right, so I have just unloaded the black and we're loading some blue. And bingo, we're ready to go back and set our colors. Go to prepare. I'm going to switch to object mode. It's so simple to just click on these and bounce through the different colors to try and get a pattern that you think is awesome. I'm going to go with that one right there. All right, let's do one other bonus part here. I'm going to cut a keychain hole into this. If I right click on the shape, I can add a negative part. We're simply going to add a cylinder. I am going to switch to per object mode so that way I can edit it. And then I want to scale this down so that it's the size of my keychain hole. I like to use 5 millimeters. Now I can simply use the move command to line this up exactly where I want. Let's use our view cube. That's lined up nice from the top. Let's spin around and look at it from the front. Notice we did not have it set to cut all the way through. Now it should be groovy. Look at it from a corner. And let's hit slice plate. Check it out. There is our hole cutting all the way through. And it's ready to be a keychain. It's going to take about 46 minutes. Let's hit print plate. Double check our colors, which I am happy with. And send it to the 3D printer. Of course, after a moment, it bounces to the device menu. And once it has finished downloading, we can click on play and monitor everything from afar. And about 50 minutes later, we have got a tiny little multi-color mosaic. Now, once again, the larger you make these, the more time it takes to print, but at least now you've got a technique for how to create them. All right, friends, so let's just run through a few things here. The big trick was using Sketch Tool to make that outer line so that we could cut these. If I click on this one and I do ungroup, you can see this used that same outer line trick to make the cutting tool so that way our pattern was cut off. Also, once you make one of these patterns, you can see that I did this one. It was much more tricky. When you make it though, it's still the exact same technique. I did outer line, inner line, and then I used the same duplicate and nudge. The more patterns you make, you can simply save them and bring them back in other projects. If you've never copied between projects, I've got tutorials for that step as well. Once again, if you bring in a cool SVG, I recommend you trace the outside of the SVG as well, just because having access to those cool stroke tools is so darn powerful. As I wrap up, I want to say thanks to Ryan and Nate for the question. Tons of fun learning about mosaics, and I'm looking forward to making awesome ones in the future. Remember, if you ever make one that you're proud of, you can always share it with the HLMT23 tag, and I'll check it out. I do also want to say thank you to everybody that support me via YouTube memberships. Remember, there are 3 different levels of support, starting as low as $5 a month. And with any level of support, you get early access to videos. I also want to say thank you to everybody that's part of my Patreon. Love how that group is growing. There is a fantastic messaging tool. You can check it out and learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget, every time you hit that like button and share a video, add a comment down below, or hit subscribe, you're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day, and keep tinkering.